Around the World with MS World, I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, Chief Medical Correspondent. We're here at the American Academy of Neurology annual meeting, and aside from hearing about medications and hearing about different ways of testing multiple sclerosis, we also try to understand MS more fundamentally. And that's why I'm so happy to be joined here by Dr. Bob LisaK, who is the Parker Weber Chair of Neurology at Wayne State University and Professor of Immunology, Biochemistry, and Microbiology. Thank you so much for joining us. What are we learning about MS that we didn't understand? Haven't we figured it all out by now?
No, we haven't figured it all out, and we certainly haven't figured out the immunopathology of different parts of MS, gray matter versus white matter versus deep gray matter. And the pathogenic mechanisms, although they're probably all immune-mediated, may be very different, and that's important to understand those because the therapeutic approach of what type of immunopathogenic mechanism might change which therapy you should use for which. And one of the big mysteries is what causes the cortical gray matter problems in patients with all stages of MS, including very early on. So we've been interested in the B cells, which we know are in the meninges in all stages of MS, and the cortical gray matter is involved with no evidence of antibody or complement activation. And so what are those inflammatory cells making? And we've focused on the B cells, collaborating with Amit Bar-Or from McGill, who's now at the University of Pennsylvania, one of my old haunts. And what we found is that the B cells in culture from MS patients but not controls make something or some factors that, at least in tissue culture, will kill oligodendrocytes and kill neurons and not astrocytes or microglia. And now we're trying to figure out what it is. And we've sort of narrowed down what it isn't, but what we think we have is that it's something of a higher molecular weight, and using a kit or prep that isolates microvesicles, primarily something called exosomes, which cells, all cells, butt off. We think it's the exosomes that are causing the killing, which then leads us to what's in the exosomes in MS versus normals, or is it just a quantitative? Do the B cells from MS release more? And these are probably released locally. It's not like an antibody that circulates. And by the cells getting into the nervous system, they are probably, we think, releasing something locally that then the exosome opens up and secretes what they call its cargo. And its cargo can include microRNA and take over the metabolism. People are interested in microRNA as a biomarker, but it could be a toxin. Lipids like ceramide and sphingomyelin are in there, and then cytokines and other things are in there when B cells make the exosome. And we didn't detect them being elevated in MS versus controls in the free soup, because if they're stuck in the exosome, you don't detect them in the assay, but when they open up locally near a cell, they target the cell. So that's the last part is speculation, but we think it's important. So our big emphasis now is to try to characterize, are these definitely exosomes or some other microvesicle? Because how you would interfere with it would be different for different types. And then is it a quantitative or a qualitative difference between MS and controls? Because we know that the cortical disease is a better correlate with progression and permanent disability than is the demyelination.
If this is something that's inside a microvesicle, is there a way that we can maybe block whatever's released or stop that from happening? Can that help MS?
Well, I mean, if you knew it was the microvesicle, there would be potentially ways to stop them from being released. If you knew what it was in the microvesicle, you might be able to just block that. Our current B-cell therapy with the monoclonals is essentially to eliminate them, at least the circulating ones. It would be nice if we could just interfere with what they're doing we don't like. We know some of the earlier drugs affect B-cell function, trap B-cells, block B-cells from getting into the nervous system. So that's all good, but it would be nice to be a little bit more specific if we knew it was an exosome and we knew what was in the exosome that we'd like to block, because that would be more specific. And potentially, if it's more specific, it theoretically might be less side effects, less broad-based.
Dr. LisaK, thank you so much for explaining to us what's really a difficult concept, but really can help us understand how understanding MS better can potentially translate into us actually figuring out how to treat MS better as well.
That's the idea.
And that's the idea, to get medications that can be strong and effective, but be very targeted and have less side effects.
Right.
I want to thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, take care.
Thank you.